Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Roller Derby City Track. I am King Crazy.
And I am Julia Sleezer.
And coming up for you next, we will have in white, the Power of Scotland, the men's roller derby. And they will be up against in black, Team Belgium. This is both teams. This is their second bout of the day. Scotland took the victory earlier against Team Japan. It was 247-103, I believe. And Belgium were beaten 255-20 by Team Canada. So with a very loud Scottish contingent in the crowd.
Yes.
So I don't know if any of you were watching the Scotland-Japan game from a little while ago. I dare say even on the loud live feed, you could hear the crowd. It was immense. For any of you that were at the MERDC last year, it was louder than the final between the Quad Guards and SDRD. But anyway, we're ready to get underway. Taking the jam line first for the Power of Scotland, it's 2D, Nuke Jukem. And he's up against number 88, that is Trick or Treat. So, here we go, here we go, here we go. And just that tense, those last few moments before the game starts. Looks like we're starting this one a little early. A couple of minutes early starting. Unheard of in roller derby terms, and away we go. And straight away, both jammers forced to the inside, forced to recycle. And we have the first power jam. Nuke Jukem picks up the penalty for the track cut.
Looks like Phantom was called on a cut track.
There's another penalty gone. I couldn't see who it was. It was one of the Belgian skaters. I believe it's Niels on wheels.
He committed.
Trick or Treat having a tough time getting through the front of that pack, but he just does it now. The first lead jammer goes to the guys from Belgium.
Looks like Scotland has got a wall ready for him already, though.
That's a good four wall there, bridging well. Number 19, which is Gerda Jam, doing a great job holding him back. Just as I say that, Trick or Treat gets three, five in the sky. There he goes, approaches on the second scoring pass. Once again, passive offense being employed. WKD's going for failure to reform.
Looks like
he's off to the quad skate shot penalty box.
Scotland's jammer is back in play and busting through the pack.
I'm not sure if that was lovely footwork or just trying to hold his balance. Whatever it was, it worked. He got three.
Good to look at regardless.
14 points though, picked up on that first jam. So fast girl skates, serving skaters of all shapes and sizes since 2007. Number 18, Tequila Jammer, takes the jam line this time for the Power of Scotland.
Looks like Niels on wheels is going to be jamming for Belgium.
Looks like 3-on-3 in the pack. A little bit of jammer-on-jammer action to start with, but the outside line opens up. Tequila just taken out. Big hit there by Phantom. And Niels and Wills picks up the cut track. But there's also a misconduct penalty picked up by Tequila Jammer, so both jammers will sit down. Niels and Wills sat down just first. And he has been told by the NSOs to go back on track, he just didn't realise. In the meantime, Tequila Jammer's through. And he completes his initial pass. Now, because we've had both jammers go to the box, this jam will now go the full 2 minutes. Cut track signalled on 24, Phantom. Tequila Jammer now looking to put the first points on the board for the Power of Scotland. And getting a push through. And there we go. Is that 4 points signalled by Rocky Horaha, our jam referee?
Looks like the Belgium jammer is being hung up in the back from some hard hits from the Power of Scotland.
Yeah, real tough time. Red Baron doing the majority of the damage there. But he's also being helped out by, I believe it's T-Virus. Well, I could be wrong, unless the number's wrong. In the meantime, that was, waiting for the point, 5-point natural grand slam. Niels and Wills having a tough time.
Looks like we're going to have a star pass. Niels on Wills, oh. Two.
Tequila Jammer just on the way through, taking out Wimplash, the pivot, who's on the recipient of the star pass.
Oh, he's got the Jammer Penta in his hand. I don't think he can pass it back on his way to the box.
Because I think the rules are, as they stand right now, because we're not playing under the new rule set yet.
Yeah.
As they stand right now, as soon as the Jammer is in control of the pivot, they take, I think they take Jammer status. So the penalty, I think they serve it as a Jammer.
Right.
Maybe not.
Oh, okay.
Because Murdoch has come out, number 62, and he does have the star on his head.
I think we were right in the first place. So as soon as he takes the panty, but before he puts it on his head, he is the Jammer, but he's technically inactive.
Yeah. I think we're going to get there's going to be a delay of game penalty here, hopefully.
I think it may be.
We will have one of the referee alternates will come over and tell us exactly what's going on. In the meantime, Green Monster Roller Sports, all new. Visit us today at greenmonster.com. That's Green Monster without the vowels, GRNMNSTR.com. Saying this jam is brought to you by the Roller Derby City, Europe's largest supplier of Roller Derby kit and merch. And we have Murdoch, and he is up against the real Scrim Shady. Both Jammers having a tough time. And Scrim Shady's through, but he's not lead. There's a no pass, no penalty signaled. So Murdoch could still get lead Jammer. Bonnie's hit the floor on turn one there. I'll let the Zebra sort that one out because I've not got a clue who's done what.
Looks like Murdoch has lead Jammer for Team Belgium.
But Scrim Shady has picked up 4 points. Sorry, 5 points. Okay, a little bit of confusion. Scrim Shady thought he'd got a penalty. He hadn't. He was told to return to the track. So hopefully things will calm down a little bit and we get our heads around exactly what's going on. And tell you lovely people at home. In the meantime, 2D Newt Jukem for the Power of Scotland.
And 404, Germanius for Team Belgium.
So 23 and a half minutes to go. Belgium in the black, 16. Power of Scotland in the white, 21. Scotland know that if they win this, that should be enough to put them through to the quarterfinals tomorrow. And both Jammers having a real tough time getting through there. Some very strong, very physical defense. But Lee Jammer goes to Geronimus. The AB Reckless, one of my favourite derby names, makes his way to the quadscape shot penalty box. One point there picked up by Belgium, none for Scotland. Don't forget, skate with the Blue Streak. Fast Girl Skates, designers of the Blue Streak boot, with unparalleled comfort, fit, style and performance. And we have 1998, it's T-Virus for Scotland, up against the captain, 1030, Track Vader for Team Belgium. T-Virus thought he'd found a line down the outside, unable to get through. Track Vader having a tough time. Lee Jammer was called, but he then picked up the track cut. So, Captain Track Vader, power jam, but not lead jammer. So this jam will go the full 2 minutes as well.
Scotland seems to have some of the good strategy with their walls and holding the jammer back, but Belgium is powering through it.
out of play penalty called on number 19. That's Judah Jam. Despite the best efforts of Red Baron, another five in the sky picked up there by Track Vader.
Team Belgium clearly coming together to try to get their jammer through against the remaining Scottish players.
Very good offense there by B.A.B. Reckless. Clearing out the path for Track Vader to pick up the point. Is he going to call it? Is he going to keep going? He's keeping going as T-Virus now returns to the track.
Actually, I think since the opposite jammer went to the box during his initial pass, or after having been called lead, this is going to be a full 2 minute jam.
Yep. Yeah, T-Virus did pick up lead jammer status before he got sent to the box, but he's just been sent to the floor. Number 77, Rocky Ball Bowering, and he took out the referee, jam referee, Rocky Horoho. There were Rockies everywhere. Like being in Colorado. In the meantime, T-Virus gets 4 points. So 4 points for the Power of Scotland. Track Vader on a tough last pass, picks up another three. So 10 minutes in, 20 to go. 40 points for Belgium. 25, is that for Team Scotland? And Tequila Jammer once more with the star for Team Scotland. Power of Scotland in the white, of course. And he's up against Murdoch, number 62 for Team Belgium, wearing black. Scrum start, bodies hit on the floor, left, right and centre. Porky the penetrator, taking out Murdoch, but Lee Jammer goes through the... It is Tequila Jammer. What have we got here? We have a back block major signaled on Tequila Jammer. So once more, this will be a power jam for the team in black, Team Belgium. And again, as Tequila Jammer did have lead jammer, this jam will go the full 2 minutes. There's a chance now for Murdoch to see what he can do and see. Oh, Porky the penetrator with a big hit times two. And that time he's got called for forearms. Out of play call, five in the sky. Belgium look like they're employing the passive offense. Oh no, one goes forward, tries to clear a path. Murdoch recycled back by WKD.
It's just a matter of getting past these remaining two Scottish players.
I think that's Conenberg, gets the direction of play penalty. So he will make his way to the quadskate shot penalty box.
And the Scottish jammer has re-entered the track and the pack.
Did he keep his feet in there? He did. Lovely footwork, balancing on his toe stops as he went round there. Pick up 4 points for Team Scotland. And that's the end of that jam. And what we're seeing is a couple of power jams. A couple of Scottish jammers going to the quad skate shop penalty box. Quad skate shop, Europe's original brick and mortar roller derby equipment supplier. Quad roller skate shop has the best selection and the most stock of any store on the continent, with excellent consultation services that only a fellow skater can provide. Got all your needs covered because we love this game.
So next up for Team Scotland, we're going to have number 976, the Real Scrim Shady, up against Belgium's Meals on Wheels.
1-0-1-0, is that?
It is. Cannot tell who just got lead.
It looks like Scrim Shady has lead. I believe Jam Ref Rocky Horoho has his hand in the air. Yep.
Meals on Wheels just got mowed over into the centre.
And B.A.B. Reckless makes his way to the penalty box. In the meantime, he gets through. There's another penalty call there. Back blocked by the looks of it. on 1-1-1-1, who is Johnson. On the jam, and my apologies. So that was, I believe it was Scrim Shady, another power jam. Jammer penalties are absolutely killing Power of Scotland in this game.
They sure are.
Porky the penetrator and number 19 are out on track trying to hold him up. Jutta jam. And Porky's going to take him all the way back. Connor Bowe's gone to the back. Oh my word, there's penalties going left, right and centre. Schumer Track, I think, is taking a seat. He's been told to go all the way around because there's no room at the end. We're having a cake sale over there.
It's currently two from Team Scotland versus one from Belgium. The jammer just got through with 5 points.
And that was Bulldog, who I believe he picked up a failure to reform penalty, but because there's no space in the box, he'll have to stay on and queue. That's 3-2 Bulldog for Belgium in the black. Out comes Scrim Shady.
Niels on Wheels is really getting held up in this just by a few Scottish players, but he makes it through. Scrim Shady not far behind.
Porky making his way back to the box. So the NSA having a tough time. Stopwatches working overload.
I do not currently envy the penalty box.
I was going to say, yeah. We've got a fantastic set of NSOs, and we need to thank them massively for all the work that they do, especially with things like that, because that's really going to keep them busy. 15 minutes to go, 70 to Belgium, 37 to the Power of Scotland. It's not over yet. If Scotland can keep their jammers on the track, when it's even strength, Scotland have had the advantage. But the problem that they've had is keeping the jammers on track. So let's see what Nuke Dukin can do this time.
He's going to be up against Jeremonius from Belgium, who's just gotten lead jammer.
And Nuke Dukin is through. He is right behind him, but Jeremonius does have lead jammer. Scotland trying to get to the front. Let's see the points. 3 points for Scotland and 2 for Belgium on that last jam. So Nuke Dukin just kept the pace up long enough. So, but with 14 minutes to go, you can't stop the clock with a timeout in these half an hour bouts. 1 point gains for Scotland is not going to be enough. They're 32 points behind. At some point, they are going to have to pull out at least one, if not two, double-figure jams or one very big jam.
It's like Team Scotland's already lined up to try to hold the jammer back and pull their jammer through. Oh, look like they're going to be successful in doing that. Oh, and they were. Currently, with lead jammer status is number 18, Tequila from Scotland.
And this could be what Scotland need. There is a power jam. The calls, it's a forearms, I believe, on Trick or Treat. It may be elbows. We need to find a way for the ref's hand signals to distinguish this a bit more. But in the meantime, 5 in the sky for Tequila Jammer. So it was 32 points difference at the start of this jam. See what it is at the end. Another 5 points picked up. A little bit of offense going on, trying to create, make it a little bit easier for Tequila to get through.
Ooh, that was very nicely done by Scotland's Tequila, juking his way through the pack. Picking up another 5 points for Scotland.
T-Virus, in the meantime, makes his way to the box for a track cut. Tequila Jammer gets another 5 points.
Belgium's jammer has just stood in the box. There's about 40 seconds left. Oh.
The Scottish fan club getting right behind. Another 4 points. 24 points was that picked up on that jam? Was that 34? So. Can't see it from here.
Currently the score is Belgium 72 to Scotland 64.
So if you're enjoying listening to this, and drops a little bit of money to via the link on the broadcast. The money that you donate is split 50-50 between the broadcast costs and the team's travel expenses.
Starting off this jam, we've got number 976 from Scotland, who's just taken lead jammer status, while the Belgium jammer has just re-entered the track from the box.
Scrimshady now trying to do his best to pick up some points quickly for Team Scotland, for the Power of Scotland. Doesn't want to risk, calls the jam off, didn't want to risk the track cut. 3 points. So, Fast Girl Skates offers unparalleled expertise, customer service and fast economical shipping. Visit us at www.fastgirlskates.com for league and military discounts. 11 minutes to go, 5 points in it, 72 to Belgium in the black, 67 to the Power of Scotland in white. Nuke Jukum and Track Vader on the jam lines, and we have a GBEMS pivot line start. Nuke Jukum picks up lead jammer once more for Scotland. Power of Scotland now seem to be getting into their game, not picking up the city penalties. And he's through for a 5-point Grand Slam. WKD just can't stop Track Vader at the front.
The last pass ties up the score at 72-72.
Any points picked up on this one, and that will be probably 3. I believe that was 3 points. And
yes,
we have a timeout signalled by Team Belgium. So the Men's Roller Derby Association would like to wish all the teams competing in the Men's Roller Derby World Cup the best of luck this weekend. The MRDA is the international governing body for men's flat track roller derby and wants you to join them in the growing world of men's roller derby. For more information about joining and the benefits of being part of the MRDA, visit them at mensrollerderbyassociation.com or send inquiries to info@mensrollerderbyassociation.com. And also, if you're enjoying watching this at home, look us up on Instagram under MRDWC. Share your photos, yourself enjoying the feed, enjoying the broadcast, enjoying the bounce, enjoying the whole event. Send them in to us, and who knows, some of them, maybe yours, will appear on the stream.
Sounds like we're about ready to get started again. We've got Dead Hardy, number 42 for Scotland, up against Murdoch, number 62 for Belgium.
So it's the first time Dead Hardy has had the jammer star in this bout. 3-point lead for Scotland, 9 minutes to go. Ah, Murdoch straight away forces Dead Hardy to the outside, forces him to drop back by a little time. But Dead Hardy is straight back through and picks up Lee Jenner. So here he goes. And Duff McKegger forcing Murdoch to drop back a long, long way to recycle him there. Hardy in the meantime through. 5-point natural Grand Slam.
So the Belgium jammer hasn't even made it through his initial pass so far. He's really fighting for it.
And I believe we're going to have a power jam.
Yeah,
Murdoch has picked up the penalty. Track cup called. Dead Hardy calls off the jam. So Fast Girl Skates, their knowledgeable staff represent all facets of roller derby, WFTDA, USARS, MRDA, JRDA and Banked. They can relate to what you need. Larger selection on skate and gear for everyone, women, men, juniors. It's about you.
Starting off this next jam, we're going to have a power jam for the Power of Scotland with tequila number 18.
And tequila jammer is through. He is your lead jammer. So currently has the 10-point lead for the Power of Scotland in white. On this power jam, they're going to have the best part of a minute for it. Let's see how many points he can, how far can he extend that lead. There's 5.
Team Belgium has a wall already set up for him. Let's see if he can make it through it.
Jutter jam going on, a bit of offense, trying to create a hole through. Some strong work from number 88 for Belgium, Trick or Treat. Decent defense there, and the track cut, it's worked. It was the pivot again, Trick or Treat, number 88, that forced the penalty. So we'll have a jammer switcheroo. And I believe that's Murdoch that's coming back on the track.
It is.
Scotland do have the full four blockers. And everybody seems to be right on the inside line of turn three. There's a penalty, it's a direction of play penalty been given. And it is Red Baron who's got it. WK Deeds on his way to the box. I think it was a failure to reform. 1-1-1-1. Johnson gets a failure to reform. Murdoch was offered the star pass by Trick or Treat but chose not to take it. An out of play penalty was called, so Murdoch can carry on. I think that's Juddajam. There's just one blocker on it. There are two blockers. No, there is just the one blocker on track for Scotland. But there's also a jammer on track. Picked up the 4 points. End of the jam.
Tequila came on just at the end of the jam. Usually we would expect a much shorter stay in the box when there's a jammer switch like that. But Belgium's jammer was already standing when Tequila entered, so he was going to serve the better part of a minute again.
So, 5 minutes to go, 91 plays 82. And we have an official timeout. As Geronimus there was a little keen to get going, sprinted forward and stopped just in time. Official timeouts, probably a little bit of clarification with the penalties with the NSIs. So in the meantime, like I say, if you are enjoying watching the feed, please click the link on the If you are enjoying watching us on the feed, please click on the link on the Men's Roller Derby World Cup, MRDWC website. Donate us a little bit of cash, whether it be pounds, dollars, euros, yen, whatever it is, Vietnamese dong, anything. We'll take anything. We're not fussy. The money is split between the broadcast costs that we've had here and the travel costs for the teams. As I say, some of the teams, not so much these two, but teams like Argentina, teams like Japan, teams like Australia, US and Canada have travelled a hell of a long way to get here. I'm sure they'd appreciate the money as well. And we've also had a tweet from Amy Leary, who doesn't seem to be, monogamy's not necessarily her strong point, because she wants to marry all of Team Scotland. Amy, yeah, I think the vicar might have a word with you about that one. I'm not quite sure how legal that is, but yeah, best of luck, darling.
I will ask later in person for you.
Yeah, you heard that, Amy. Julius Fleece is on it for you. We'll find out. Now, of course, this is playing into Scotland's hand because unless it's an injury, the clock does not stop. So that's probably taken about a minute off the clock.
It should have, yes.
Three and a half.
Oh, sorry. No, there was an official timeout, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was
an official. I thought it was a team timeout, sorry. But yeah, I think it mowed off just about a minute.
And again, we now have a team timeout, this time taken by the Power of Scotland. Again, perhaps possibly running down the clock, realising that the clock's their friend. And just trying to basically kill the game off.
Well, when there's such a close score, I mean, it would be in many ways strategic to do so if you were concerned. Both of these teams have been fairly aggressive. Even the jammers are very, very aggressive.
So, and the other thing is, of course, with Scotland, they know having beaten Japan earlier today, they win this, then the chances are, like, almost guarantees them a place in the quarterfinals tomorrow. Belgium know, having lost to Canada, they need to win this to have a realistic chance of qualifying. And even then, that depends on them beating those very, very entertaining boys from Japan. If you didn't see that bout earlier, next time Japan are on is on this track at 4 o'clock against Canada on the Roller Derby City track. You want to watch that. So back to the action. 2 minutes now to go. Geronimus and the Real Scrim Shady. Scotland in white, Belgium in black. Scotland with a 9-point lead.
Looks like we've got.
And also Lee Jammer. And that could be enough now for Scrim Shady just to run the clock down. And Juddajam is doing a great job holding back the jammer, who's Geronimus, but he's gone to the box. Ooh, Scrimshade, he's called it. Interesting, you have lead, you have more points. Been tempted to run the clock myself there, but what do I know? So, Newt Jukum, Jerry, up against B.A. Be Reckless. I have to say, that has got to be my favourite skate name that I've seen so far, B.A. Be Reckless.
Right?
I really do like that one.
Nice.
So there's one on the Canada team, which I hope I don't get wrong later. The ABF just runs into Porky. You don't want to be doing that, son. That's not a good move.
But Newt Jukum has got lead for Team Scotland. Oh, sorry, the power of Scotland in white.
And Jaffa Skate's trying to draw the track up there, but unsuccessfully. B.A.B. Reckless is now through. Completed his initial pass. And Jem's been called, 40 seconds to go. Now, just remember, the clock, the whistle, the game will be blown dead at the 30-minute mark. It won't run to the end of that jam. So this jam, to be honest, will probably only run for about 10 to 12 seconds. Real Scrimshady versus, I believe that's Fantoum on the jammer line.
It is.
Scotland with the 16-point lead.
It's going to be about a 10-second jam coming up.
So here we go, last jam of this bout.
Both teams really holding back the opposing jammer.
And that's it, that's the game. That should be enough for Scotland to go through and see them into the quarterfinals. Just to give you a quick heads up of what we have coming up for you. Pretty much in the next couple of minutes on the other feed, on the Quad Skate Shop feed, it will be Germany versus France. So that's on the Quad Skate Shop feed, Germany versus France, starting in a couple of minutes' time. The next bout here on this feed at 5 o'clock is Team England versus Team Sweden. So that will be the next bout that we have on here. So, I have been King Crazy.
Thank you very much, Julius Leeser.
And I'm sure we'll see you both later in the weekend.